सो लेट मी ड्रैग एंड ड्रॉप द फाइल्स. नेक्स्ट. ओके, आई नीड टू गिव पब्लिक परमिशन, दैट इज फॉर श्योर. ग्रांट पब्लिक रीड ओनली एक्सेस. इफ यू डोंट गिव दिस, द होम पेज विल नॉट लोड. ओके, नाउ properties, static website hosting. Just go to this URL. Are you getting the same thing? So the basic point is, as long as it is working in your machine, you can upload the same website over here. Okay, so you can put all the videos, MP3 files and all of that. For example, you can create a video site like YouTube. Okay, and basically with all of the JavaScript and HTML, you can make it work. Okay. So, but for that, for logging in, you need to have some other service, OAuth services and all of that. I'm not getting into all of that. So let us assume that we want to create a YouTube without login feature, then you can easily do it over here. Okay, fine. So can we write our websites in S3? And this is the most cheapest way to host it. So you already have a URL and you can put the basic HTML and JavaScript and you can build your own website. Okay, so this is an extra feature which these guys come up with. And now the important question is, why this feature? Enduku? Why AWS has to put an extra effort to build this feature? Okay, this discussion will lead to something called as CDN, Content Delivery Networks. Okay, what is CDN? Okay, YouTube is a CDN, TV9 Telugu is a CDN. Okay, so and basically Times of India is a CDN. Okay, so content delivery, they deliver the contents and people across the world try to read that, and they wanted to use S3 for that purpose. So what they do is, they integrate something called as CloudFront, they integrate it with S3 and they give content delivery networks. Okay, where, for example, we have seen the video in the earlier case, right? Video is a heavy file, and when, let us assume that my server is in Mumbai and someone from US is trying to access it, it takes time for him to stream that data. So how can I reduce that? How can I reduce that streaming so that everyone in the world should be able to access that content easily? So that concept is CDN. Okay, and CDN in AWS world is achieved through CloudFront solutions. So AWS has this feature to support that. Okay, so if AWS didn't wanted that feature, there is no point in hosting it as a website. Okay, so that's the reason. That's going to be our next topic for discussion, right? Okay, so are we clear now? Can we host static websites now? Can we change the objects life cycles now? Yeah, can we basically change the permissions? When I say permissions, it is only public, and I'm speaking about read and not read permissions. Okay, I'm not speaking about the customized permissions. For that, we'll be learning about S3 bucket policy, right? And now let us start our discussion on backup. How can I use this as a backup kind of a solution? Okay, so let us just dive one level deeper into this. AWS. Till here, do we have any doubts on this? I think this is the most simplest solution. Okay. Yes. Change, you can change. So for that, for changing the URL, you need to go with DNS servers. And the DNS service in Amazon is called as Route 53. So if you use a combination of Route 53 and S3, you can change. You can have something like my website, okay, just for testing.com will take you to that. So for that, you need to play with basically the DNS servers, right? Okay. So backup strategies. I'll be just introducing to you. Don't worry about that. I'll be finishing all of this and all. Okay. So because I need answer to two simple questions. Okay, what is difference between backup and archive? బ్యాకప్ లో కంప్రెస్ చేస్తావా? ఐఎమ్ నాట్ స్పీకింగ్ అబౌట్ 7-zip ఆర్కైవ్ ఆర్ జిప్ ఆర్కైవ్. ఐఎమ్ జస్ట్ స్పీకింగ్ అబౌట్ బ్యాకింగ్ అప్ ద డేటా అండ్ ఆర్కైవింగ్ ద డేటా. వాట్ ఇస్ ద డిఫరెన్స్? దట్స్ ఫైన్. జస్ట్ ఈస్ దట్ ద ఓన్లీ డిఫరెన్స్? వెన్ విల్ యూ డూ బ్యాకప్ అండ్ వెన్ విల్ యూ డూ ఆర్కైవల్? స్టోరేజ్ తగ్గించడానికి ప్రాబబ్లీ లెట్ అస్ అస్యూమ్ దట్ వీ హావ్ అన్లిమిటెడ్ స్టోరేజ్, దెన్ విల్ యూ డూ బ్యాకప్ ఆర్ ఆర్కైవల్? యాక్చువల్లీ ఇట్ ఈస్ అదర్ వే అరౌండ్. ఆర్కైవల్ టేక్స్ మోర్ టైమ్ దెన్ బ్యాకప్. ఓకే, సో లెట్ మీ టెల్ యూ వన్ ఇంట్రెస్టింగ్ స్టోరీ విచ్ ఐ జనరలీ టెల్ డ్యూరింగ్ దిస్. ఓకే, ఐ హావ్ జాయిన్డ్ ఇన్ అన్ ఆర్గనైజేషన్ ఇనీషియలీ. సో వీ వర్ బేసికలీ ప్రింటర్ మ్యానుఫ్యాక్చరింగ్ కంపెనీ. వెన్ ఐ సే ప్రింటర్, ఇట్ ఇస్ నాట్ ద డెస్క్టాప్ ప్రింటర్స్, దోస్ ఆర్ ఇండస్ట్రియల్ ప్రింటర్స్ విచ్ ఆర్ యూస్ టు లేబుల్ ద ప్రొడక్ట్స్ ఆర్ ఆన్ పెట్ ఆర్ కోక్ బాటిల్స్ యూ వుడ్ బి సీయింగ్ ద ప్రైస్ అండ్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దట్, రైట్? సో ఆర్ కంపెనీ యూస్ టు మ్యానుఫ్యాక్చర్ దట్. సో వీ యూస్ టు రైట్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ కోడ్. ఓకే, అండ్ ద కోడ్ వాజ్ బీయింగ్ స్టోర్డ్ ఇన్ వర్షన్ కంట్రోల్ సిస్టమ్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ VSS ఎట్ దట్ పాయింట్. ఓకే, అండ్ బేసికలీ ఆర్ అడ్మిన్ వాట్ హీ యూస్ టు డూ ఇస్ ఫర్ ఎవ్రీ వీక్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ ద VSS డేటా, ఓకే, హీ యూస్ టు లోడ్ ఇన్ టు ఎ మ్యాగ్నెటిక్ టేప్. ఓకే, అండ్ డ్యూరింగ్ ఎవ్రీ వెడ్నెస్డే, హీ యూస్ టు కాల్ మీ, బికాస్ ఐ అండ్ హీ యూస్ టు గో, హీ యూస్ టు డిపాజిట్ దట్ ఇన్ ద బ్యాంక్ లాకర్ ద టేప్. ఓకే, అండ్ ఐ యూస్ టు ఎంజాయ్ ద టీ డ్యూరింగ్ దట్ మూమెంట్. సో దట్స్ ద స్టోరీ. ఓకే, సో వై డూ థింక్ హీ హాస్ డన్ దట్? కోడ్ మొత్తాన్ని ఒక మ్యాగ్నెటిక్ టేప్ లో తీసుకెళ్లి బ్యాంక్ లో పెడతాను లాకర్ లో ప్రతి వారం. సేఫ్టీయా చేస్తామా? సేఫ్టీ. వాట్ ఇస్ వాట్ దెన్ వాట్ డూ మీన్ బై సేఫ్టీ? వాట్ ఇస్ ద నీడ్ ఫర్ దట్? యా, డిజాస్టర్ రికవరీ. సో వెన్ ఎవర్ మై కంపెనీ ఇస్ దేర్ సమ్ అన్ఫార్చునేట్ ఇన్సిడెంట్ దట్ హ్యాపెన్స్, అండ్ ఎస్పెషలీ వీ వర్ వర్కింగ్ ఆన్ ప్రింటర్స్ అండ్ ఇన్ సమ్ ఆఫ్ ద ప్రింటర్స్ ద ఇంక్ వాజ్ హైలీ ఇన్ఫ్లేమబుల్. సో ఇఫ్ ద కంపెనీ ఈవెన్ క్యాచెస్ ద ఫైర్ దెన్ వీ షుడ్ నాట్ లూజ్ అవర్ కోడ్, దట్స్ అ హోల్ ఇంటెన్షన్. ఓకే, సో వీ యూస్ టు హ్యావ్ సర్వర్ విత్ ఆల్ ద ఫైర్ సేఫ్టీ, బట్ స్టిల్ వీ యూస్ టు టేక్ ద టేప్ అండ్ పుట్ ఇట్ ఇన్ అ బ్యాంక్ లాకర్ ఫర్ డిపాజిట్. ఓకే, నా దిస్ ఈజ్ ఆర్కైవల్. ఓకే, వాట్ ఎవర్ మై అడ్మిన్ వాజ్ డూయింగ్ వాస్ ఆర్కైవల్. ఓకే, అండ్ దెర్ వాజ్ అదర్ థింగ్ విచ్ యూస్ టు డూ. సో బేసికలీ వాట్ ఎవర్ కోడ్ దట్ వాస్ బీయింగ్ కాపీడ్ ఇన్ టు వన్ సర్వర్, ఓకే, సో హీ యూస్ టు హ్యావ్ ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ ద సేమ్ కాపీ, ఓకే, ఆన్ అ డిఫరెంట్ సర్వర్. అలాంటి కాపీనే ఇంకో సర్వర్లో కూడా ఉండేది. ఓకే, దిస్ ఐ వుడ్ కాల్ ఇట్ యాజ్ బ్యాకప్. ఓకే, సో బ్యాకప్ వాట్ హ్యాపన్స్ ఇస్ బ్యాకప్ బేసికలీ ఈజ్ ఫర్ అ స్పీడీ రికవరీ. ఓకే, యువర్ సర్వర్ హ్యాస్ గాన్ రాంగ్, సర్వర్ హ్యాస్ క్రాష్డ్, and then you can't basically tell your developers from stopping the working. So for that we use backup. But if it is for a long term purpose, for example, if my company catches fire, I might not be able to get the immediate solution, but I would be getting let us assume that in our earlier case the company has catched fire on Friday, but we have code till Wednesday. Till Wednesday we put it in the bank, so we would be getting the tape from the bank, we would restore that. So archival have a restore option. So these are the two important kinds of techniques which we use. One is for immediate recovery, speedy recovery, which should happen immediately. The other one is that is in case of extreme disaster. Okay, in that case we are okay even if it takes time, because copying the data from one machine to other machine happens very quickly, but the copying the data from a magnetic tape to your machine takes hell lot of time, right? So archival is for disaster recovery, or for basically we might not want to use the archive daily, but we would still keep for safety, so that even if the complete data is lost, we would get back the data. Backup is, we will have backup till yesterday, today's backup. We would take the backups basically daily, so that even if the even if the data is lost, you would be able to go to the nearest point. Okay, so archival is for disaster recovery and backup is for now common hardware failures like server crashes, server not responding. Okay, this server is not available. So how can I bring up the same data in the server? So that's what a backup is. Okay, so we would be discussing about these two things, backup and archival. And basically for archival, the best possible storage is Glacier. If you remember me, I was telling that I will not be discussing about Glacier right now. Okay, we have seen the prices yesterday, right? And Glacier's prices were very less. Okay, so that's the reason why we archive all of our data into Glacier. But to get the data, it would take one day. It would take approximately 8 to 12 hours for us to restore the data. But that is disaster recovery, right? Even if it takes 8 hours, we are okay with that. But for backup, we want it to be faster. So for backup, we would be using S3 standard frequent, infrequent or reduced redundancy based out of our cases. And in case of archival, we will be going with Glacier. And what are the different backup strategies which we would take? Archival will not have much of a strategy. You will fix to a date and you would take archive on that day and you would just say that I would take an archival of years data. So that's how it goes. But backup will have strategies. Okay, how will you take the backup? Will you take the complete copy or will you be taking the copy of what you had plus the differences? So there are multiple ways of taking the backup. That's what our backup and archival is going to cover. Okay, fine. Yeah, this is our topic of discussion for tomorrow, right? For today, I want to do something interesting. Okay, in S3 now, will you be able to create a website? Yes. Will you be able to copy files? Yeah. Change the storage classes? Okay. I want you to do all of that work in from CLI also. I want you to do all of that work from CLI also. So tomorrow I would be having half of my class discussing about this backup and archival because it is mostly theoretical. Okay, and the rest half, let us implement this S3, okay, from CLI. Okay, so tomorrow I would request you to bring your systems tomorrow, right? So tomorrow from the second, probably from 9:15 or so, we would be discussing on doing the CLI. So for that, let me show you the configuration. Okay, for the people who knows the configuration already, you can leave because we might have discussed CLI configuration many times. Okay, but for the people who are new, let us have this discussion. For the people over the web who know CLI configuration, just leave if you want, because I'm going to discuss about how to configure CLI and then I'm going to stop this class, right? Fine. Yeah, apart from compressing and you have understood the difference, right? Backup archive is basically for it is not meant for speedy recoveries. It is meant for long term kind of a recovery which contains a complete data. Backup might not contain a complete data, right? Okay. Fine, I want to basically configure CLI. Okay, today I would be showing it only on a Windows machine. I assume everyone has a Windows machine over here, right? Any other operating systems by chance? Kottaga vachina vallu Windows kaakunda vere operating system emana vaadutunnara? In on the web, for the people who have joined new, are you using any other operating system apart from Windows? Because I would be showing Ubuntu while I am discussing IAM, because that makes more sense then. Okay, so fine. What I would do is, I want you to do this AWS CLI for Windows. Okay, and then you would get this. And you are seeing MSI installer, right? Click on this and download 64 or 32 bit version, whatever your operating system is. Okay, and then what we have to do? MSI, double click and click next until it says I am done. That's it. Since Windows it is an MSI installer, right? You have to download and just go through the wizard. And after you do that, go into the PowerShell, okay, and just type AWS. Okay, you should get something. It should not say that a command not found. You should get some help like this. Okay, so or else AWS help. They should be working. Okay, you should not get an error saying that command not found. Okay, fine. Now, while installing AWS SDK or AWS CLI, did I told what is my account and where is my account? Cheppana na account ekkada undo? I didn't told to it. But to do something on S3, it should know where your account is, right? Who you are. Okay. So for that reason, what we would be doing is we would be creating a basic IAM user. Okay, we'll be diving deeper into IAM, but for today I would be showing you a very basic and easier way to create an IAM user. So what I would do is I'd go to the AWS services, and then if you scroll a bit down, you would be seeing something called as IAM. Click on this. Okay, just go to users, add user, give some name, S3 CLI user, and then you are seeing the access over here. Just give programmatic access for today. Okay, next. Okay, and you are seeing this third option, right? Attach existing policies and take the first policy, which is administrator access. Okay, we should not be doing this ideally. You want to access S3, I should give you permission only for S3. But since we don't know much about IAM, I am giving you an administrator access, which means that you can do anything. Okay, apart from billing, you can do everything. Yeah, so I'd just say next, I would say create user. And whenever you create a user, you would get this option of download CSV. Okay, so download this CSV and preserve it. This is very much required because this is something which we need to configure. What is our user's name? S3 CLI, right? Okay, let me not open it in this. Let me open it in Notepad++. Okay. So after this, what you have to do is you have this Excel the file which you have opened in Notepad++ or Notepad, and then execute the command called as AWS configure. Okay. This is a step where you are configuring the user and telling where your server is and all of the details. So AWS configure, and then it will ask you what is the access key ID, and this will be empty for you. Since I already have configured the user, it is showing me the previous user's ID. Okay, so what is the access key ID over here? I'd copy this and I'd paste this. What is the secret access key? So you are seeing the next section. So I'd copy. Okay, you have plus symbol, so that's why it is not working. So copy this till you see. Okay, and then enter it. What is the region which you are working in? Okay, every region has a code. Every region has a code. To know that, what you can do is go to the Google and type AWS region codes. Okay, you are seeing this table, right? Okay, just come down, scroll a bit down, and see what is the region which you are working on and give that code. Since I am working on Oregon's region and I'm interested in Oregon, I would be giving a code which is US West -2. Okay, so US West -2. Okay, default format is none, but I want you to work with JSON file, because if it is JSON, we can do some analytics on that. Okay, fine. Once you do this, right? Okay, so let me go into CD C drive. Once you do this, okay, you can work on commands. Okay, so for example, you can just say AWS S3 LS. We'll be understanding what that command is tomorrow, but okay, it is list all the buckets. So these are my buckets which I have. Okay, are we seeing something which we have created right now? Okay, some website, qtstaticwebsite.com. Okay, so if I want to see the contents of it, I'd be saying AWS S3, okay, S3:\qtstaticwebsite.com ls, which is the command is wrong. Okay. So it is giving me what are its contents. So we would be understanding what these commands are and how to use them. Okay, and we would be doing whatever you have done in the UI. So till today, if you have not finished anything in UI, please do finish it, because tomorrow our responsibility is to try to do whatever we have done in the UI from CLI, because this is what is important, not doing from UI. UI nun andaru chestaru, UI nun cheyadaniki pedda ventaga em ledhu, inter pillalanu kuda kuchabetti cheyochu, there is nothing difficult in that. So this is what makes sense. So you should be able to create buckets, list the contents of the buckets, move the contents of the bucket, enable versioning, all of that from CLI. Okay, so this is important. Okay, that is only for the knowledge. Okay, why we do UI is because we will know what is that we are doing. Okay, and then we will try to do the same operation from CLI. And industry is expecting the people in AWS who have knowledge, who can do it in CLI and CloudFormation, not on UI. Okay, UI aithe all existing users ne training ichukochu. S3 lo pedda em undi, it is all about uploading, and then you have options for everything. You give it to any tester, he would be able to do it, right? And they can probably do it better than what we do, because they have a hell lot of patience, right? So that is it. We are not about it, we are about this. Okay, so configure this user and execute a very simple command for today. Write down that command if you want. Okay, after you create S3 configure, and if you do AWS S3 LS, it should show you all the buckets of whatever you have created. Okay, fine. Okay, so tomorrow for the second half we'll be doing this activity. Okay, once we finish this, then we would be doing some kind of backup and archival from this also, from command line, right? Fine. Now, so backup and archival, just if you are already working, you can just have a basic idea of how they are backing up from your system and all of that. Okay, they already work on it. For the people who don't work, at least try to finish this activity, and tomorrow we'll be doing it from CLI. Okay, and I would show you one more installation. Okay, so the one more installation, which I'm not sure whether I have shown in this class or not, but I want you to install something called as Chocolaty. Chupichana idi class lo, DevOps class lo chupichanattu. So just come down, and just you are seeing install Chocolaty now, right? Click on this. Here you will not have any download and this kind of stuff. You are seeing this command, right? Copy this command and open command prompt and execute this. You would get basically Chocolaty. We would be using this. Okay, because tomorrow we'll be installing something called as Python pip and AWS. If you don't have this, you have to search for Python pip, download it, install it. But if you have Chocolaty, it is very simple to do any kind of installations, right? So we'll be using this Chocolaty. Okay, so what you have to do, Chocolaty, and then install Chocolaty, and you would be seeing a command. Copy that command and paste it onto your Windows command prompt, and then enter it. Remember, Windows command prompt you need to run as administrator. Meer ye command prompt lo idi command run chestunaro, try to run it as an administrator, because it would get into the system folders, right? Make sense? Will you make it ready? Okay, so till here, if you have ready, we can continue with our work for tomorrow, which is discussing on backup and archival strategies, and also focusing on CLI. Okay, and tomorrow I would recommend you to bring your systems. If you can't bring a system, and if you have desktop at home, at least find a friend who has laptop, so that atanu pakkana kuchochu. Okay, tomorrow you would be doing most of the work. I'd be just showcasing you basic stuff of how to do it, and let us understand that CLI, and after that we would be applying that CLI for other activities, whatever we have been doing. Okay, make sense? Right, any other things to discuss? Okay, AWS, how many of you have finished these? Just tell me. Okay, new people don't ignore Miriam and Claire. Okay, so how many of you know RDS, AWS RDS? Okay, how many of you know AWS EC2 VPC? Okay, I'm also counting on the people who are on the web. Okay, aa chethulu alage etti pettanu rendu nimishalu. Okay, and how many of you are part of projects? Why? Okay, because you don't need to be a DevOps person to really do all of that, right? So because there are certain things where we need to configure elastic load balancers, auto scalings, and all of that. That is a place where you can pitch in into it. Okay. If you are learning it for the second time, you don't have confidence, I'm okay with that. But if you know and if you are not doing it, probably yeah. A real time aspect miss out taremo. Right? If possible, try to and AWS atantha vallaki roju pani undadu, by the way. Once they have simulated the environment in normal traditional EC2 machines, what they would do is they would try to come to you, then you can use Packer and CloudFormation to make it happen, or Packer or Terraform to make it happen. So I would encourage and I want people of AWS also to participate in that. Okay. And మా బ్యాచ్ లో నేను ఒక్కడనే యాక్టివ్ గా ఉన్నానండి, మిగతా వాడు ఎవడో యాక్టివ్ గా లేరండి, ఇలాంటి పేర్లన్నీ భాస్కర్ కి పంపించండి. ఓకే, ఈ బాధితులందరితో కలిపి ఒక సంఘం స్టార్ట్ చేద్దాం. ఓకే, సో వాట్ విల్ డూ ఇస్ ద పీపుల్ హూ ఆర్ నాట్ యాక్టివ్ లెట్ అస్ ఇగ్నోర్ దెమ్, అండ్ ద పీపుల్ హూ వాంట్ టు వర్క్ ఆన్ ద ప్రాజెక్ట్ లెట్ అస్ కంబైన్ దెమ్ టు ఫార్మ్ ఏ ప్రాజెక్ట్, బికాస్ ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ వాట్ వీ డూ, ఇట్ ఈస్ వాట్ హౌ వీ డూ. So don't wait for the others who will basically wait for the dates and all of that. Okay, ippudu pandaga deepal ayipoyindi, okay, deepal ayipoyindi, dasara ayipoyindi, manchi rojulu ink levu. Okay, so every day is a very good day to start, so please start it today itself. Tomorrow Bhaskar, just remind me in the DevOps class also, so I'd speak about it. Okay, for the people who have joined new, what we are trying to do is, for the people who have finished at least two cycles in DevOps or AWS, there are some people who form a group and they try to implement the complete DevOps pipeline. Okay, and in that we have some of the AWS activities also. So for example, creating the EC2 machines and all that, how can we do it in an automated way? So these people form the groups, they decide on a project and they start working on it. Okay, so I want you to participate in that. Okay, and most of them will work and everything will be visible, they would be storing it on a GitHub and everyone will have an access to that. But just by looking at that, you will not be able to make much of a knowledge. You will be able to make a knowledge when you are able to do it. And manam try chestunna automation chaala companies lo leni automation. The automation which you are trying to do in this project is which companies, where companies want to go there, they are still not there. So that's the reason, that's where we will fit in, and we will have a better chance of answering interview questions. Okay, fine. So I would expect some more participation from the people who are especially just AWS. Okay, fine. So let us stop it at that, and let us meet tomorrow to discuss on the further backup and archival strategies and CLI. Tomorrow please bring systems, okay, or at least find a neighbor who has a system. Fine, thanks.